Lord of Lords, you are Jesus.
Jesus,
Jesus.
Baba,
you are Jesus. King of kings, Lord of lords, I worship you.
Let's begin to worship him in our own words, for just who he is to us. Lord Jesus, you are my light and my salvation, I worship you. My glory and the lifter up of my head, I worship you. My joy, my peace, I worship you. You are the light of the world, you are the bread of life. You are the good shepherd, the resurrection and the life, the way, the truth and the life. You are the one in whom we live and move and have our being. You are the true vine, there is none like you. Your name is Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Your appearance is brighter than the noonday sun. You are the one with whom nothing shall be impossible. In you we live, in you we move, in you we have our being. You are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the first and the last. You are the beginning and the end. Great and marvelous are your deeds. Just and true are all your ways. Who will not fear you and give glory to your name? Thine, O God, is the greatness, the victory, the majesty, the power. All that is in heaven and earth are yours. You are the one who is before all things. In you all things hold together. You are the day spring from on high, the bright and morning star. Hallowed be your name, Sovereign Lord God of the universe. For you, through you, and by you were all things made. Without you was not there made anything that was made. In you was life. The life is the light of men that shines in darkness. Darkness cannot comprehend it. You are the one who is our deliverer. You are the one who is our savior. You are the one who is our joy. There is none that can compare with you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name, Almighty God. Great is your faithfulness. Hallowed be your name, O God.
You are the Lord.
That the word of God says in Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, because God was with him. If you are, the Lord Jesus Christ is here right now, and if you require healing in any area of your body, I want you to touch that place with your own hand and begin to ask him to touch you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and receive your healing from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Bye bye.
For that healing we have received shall be permanent in every area of our lives. Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Please be seated in the presence of the living God. Amen. For as many as believe, today is not only the 10th day of this month of total deliverance, in the year of the presence of the Lord. And we know from Psalm 16, verse 11, that in his presence there is fullness of joy, and at his right hand are pleasures forevermore. For as many of us as believe, this day, I want to welcome you to your own day of total deliverance in Jesus' name. And it shall be so in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Many of us have experienced some form of deliverance in one way or the other before. How many of us have experienced some form of deliverance? Let's just thank the Lord for the deliverances that we have experienced. Amen. Amen. But brethren, we are now in this unique time and season of total deliverance. Because our God is the only one who changes times and seasons. That we see in Daniel chapter 2, verses 20 and 21. But who is this total deliverer? Who is this total deliverer? The Bible tells us, of course, the total deliverer, the only one who can deliver totally, is the Lord God Almighty. And that we see from Psalm 18, verses 1 to 2. Psalm 18, verses 1 to 2. Psalm 18, verses 1 and 2. He says, I will love you, O Lord, my strength. Verse 2. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. The Bible goes further and tells us in 2 Corinthians, because before we think that's an Old Testament scripture, 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 9 and 10. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 9 and 10. Can we display both verses together? It says, yes, we had the sentence of death. This is Apostle Paul speaking, writing. It says, yes, we had the sentence of death in ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in God who raises the dead, who delivered us from so great a death past, and does deliver us present, in whom we trust that he will still deliver us future. Praise the Lord. No wonder from Daniel chapter 6, verses 25 to 27. Daniel chapter 6, verses 25 to 27. The king of the world at that time, a king by the name Darius, declared, after Daniel had spent a night in the den of lions, Darius wrote to all peoples, nations, languages that dwell in all the earth, peace be multiplied to you. 26, I make a decree in every dominion of my kingdom, that men must tremble and fear before the God of Daniel. For he is the living God and steadfast forever. His kingdom is the one which shall not be destroyed, and his dominion shall endure to the end. Verse 27, he delivers and rescues, and he works signs and wonders in heaven and earth, who has delivered Daniel from the power of the lions. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And why would God deliver you? How many of us can believe God for total deliverance and are expecting total deliverance today? Amen. Why would God do it? The Bible tells us from Malachi 3, verse 6, Word of God says, behold, I am the Lord, I do not change. And of course, the scripture on which this entire church is built upon, Hebrews 13, verse 8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And for as many of us as believe, when will our own total deliverance come? When will your own total deliverance come? It's an individual question. Because the word of God tells us from 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 1 and 2. It says, we then as workers together with him also plead with you not to receive the unmerited, unearned, undeserved favor of God, the grace of God, in vain. For he says, in an acceptable time, I have heard you. And in the day of salvation, I have helped you. Behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. And the word salvation there is, I found out, is from the Greek soteria, which means deliverance. So now is the day of deliverance. Because God is the same, he does not change. His ability is there and is enduring. All he is waiting for. Someone said, every day is God's day. But the day you believe is your own day. If you will believe today, today will be your own day of deliverance, total deliverance in Jesus' name. Brethren, however, what do we need to be totally delivered from? Let's get it right. Because I remember when I always used to think about deliverance from the powers of darkness, from evil forces. And when people think of deliverance, that's the primary place people go to. But the Bible already tells us that we are heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. And for as many as believe, we have already been delivered from the power of darkness. That we see in Colossians chapter 1, verses 12 and 13. Colossians chapter 1, verses 12 and 13. It says, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. Verse 13, he not will, not shall, not maybe, he has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of his love. In fact, our Lord Jesus Christ, while he was still here on earth, told his disciples, Luke 10:19, behold, I give you power to tread on serpents and all and scorpions and every power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. And so what, as believers, do we really need total deliverance from? The Bible tells us from Psalm 18, verse 17, that we need to be totally delivered from our enemies. Psalm 18, verse 17 says we need to be delivered from our strong enemies. Psalm 18, verse 48, we need to be delivered from the violence of men. Number two, we need to be delivered, Psalm 107, verse 6, out of all our distresses. Out of all our distresses. The Lord Jesus Christ in John 16:33 says, in this world you will have distress, you will have trouble, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. Number three, what do we need to be delivered from? We need to be delivered from all our destructions. Psalm 107 verse 20, he sent his word and healed them and delivered them. That means every sickness is designed to destroy. Every sickness, every disease, every inflammation, every illness is meant for destruction. But the antidote is the word of the Lord. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them. So we need to be delivered from all our destructions. Number four, we need to be delivered also from the will of our adversaries. Because let's be clear, brethren, we have adversaries. That's why the word of God says, to him that overcomes, whatever is born of God overcomes the world. That means the world must of necessity come against us as children of God. But 1 John 5 verse 4 says, this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. So we need to be delivered, Psalm 27 verse 12, from the will of our adversaries. What else do we need to be delivered from? The Bible tells us in Psalm 34, that we, verse 4, we need to be delivered from all our fears. All our fears. Psalm 34, verse 17, it says we also need to be delivered from all our troubles. And Psalm 34, verse 19, we need to be delivered out of all afflictions. Number five, what else do we need deliverance from? Psalm 91, verse 3 tells us we need to be delivered from the snare. Don't be deceived, brethren. There are snares all over the place. From the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. We need also Psalm 18, verse 43, number 6, to be delivered from the strivings of the people, from walking like an elephant and eating like an ant. That will end in our lives today in Jesus' mighty name. And then, of course, we need deliverance. Psalm 116, verse 8, as Pastor prayed, we need our souls to be delivered from death. We need our eyes to be delivered from tears. I don't know what it is that has been causing you secret tears. This day, you will receive your total deliverance from that thing in Jesus' mighty name. And we need to be delivered from falling. We need our feet to be delivered from falling. God is able to keep you. Never again shall you fall in Jesus' mighty name. You will not fall spiritually. You will not fall physically. You will not fall matrimonially. You will not fall financially. You will not fall emotionally in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. But to whom? Who shall receive total deliverance? Who shall receive great deliverance? The Bible tells us from Psalm 18 verse 50 that great deliverance is not something we can work for. It's a gift. And it's a gift from God. He says great deliverance he gives to his king and shows mercy to his anointed, to David and his descendants forevermore. And we are in the city of David. And furthermore, who are his king? Someone will say, well, you are in the city of David, but you are not his king. Let's keep that scripture up, please. Psalm 18, verse 50. You are not a king and you are not anointed. We are, who are his king and who are those who are anointed? The Bible tells us in Revelations 1. I love Jesus. Revelations 1, verses 5 and 6. It says, grace to you and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, the ruler over the kings of the earth, to him who loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, and not will make us, and has made us kings and priests to his God and Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Revelations 5, verses 9 and 10, by two or three witnesses, let every truth be established. And they sang a new song, saying, you are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood, out of every tribe and tongue and people and nation, and have made us kings and priests to our God, and we shall reign upon the earth. Praise the Lord! What is then the outcome and the product and result of total deliverance? When God totally delivers, the delivered enters into a permanent place of prosperity and promotion. For as many of us as we receive our total deliverance, this day we will enter into our own season, a permanent place of prosperity and promotion in Jesus' mighty name. And that we see from Daniel 6:28, when Daniel emerged from the den of lions. Not only did he never go back there again, but those who put him there went there. Amen. Number one. And then number two, verse 28, Daniel prospered and remained at the top for 60 years. And God is no respecter of persons. Again, in the story which we're very familiar with of the three Hebrew children, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, when they were delivered from the fiery furnace of Nebuchadnezzar, flames that were so hot that people that threw them in, the fire killed them. In Daniel 3, verse 30, when they came out of the fiery furnace, they not only came out without any injury whatsoever. The Bible tells us that fire had no power on them. The hair on their head was not singed. Their garments were not affected. This from verse 27. And even the smell of fire was not on them. By the time God finishes with you and totally delivers you, even the slightest tint of that issue, of that situation, will not be on you in Jesus' mighty name. And in verse 30, the king then promoted them. And they remained eternally promoted until the time when they went to be with the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So how then can we be delivered? We're going to examine, since we're in the city of David, we're going to look at the example and experience of David in 1 Samuel 30, where within one day, David lost everything he had worked for the 13 years before that time. And God Almighty intervened. And within that one day, he not only recovered everything, but within a month, the promise of kingship that God gave to him after he was anointed by Samuel came to pass. And I want to announce to somebody here today, I don't know what you have been believing God for, which seems it has taken a long time for it to manifest. After today, within the next 30 days, in this same month of April, there will be a manifestation in Jesus' mighty name. And the Bible tells us in 1 Samuel chapter 30. If we quickly open our Bibles, yeah, we don't have time, so I'll just quickly paraphrase. Amen. David had just been fired. The Philistines had rejected him. The people he ran to after Saul was hounding him in 1 Samuel, from 1 Samuel 17 through to 1 Samuel 29, he was running everywhere from Saul. He ran to Achish, the king of Gath, who was a Philistine king. And he was with him for a while. The king gave him a city to dwell in called Ziklag. After a number of years, they then went to go and fight Saul. The Philistines now decided to take out Saul totally. They went to invade Israel. And David went with Achish to go and fight on the side of Achish for against the army of Israel under Saul. But the Philistines rejected him. Not only did they reject him, they told him to depart from them. So he had just lost his source of livelihood. And he and the 600 men with him went back home. In 1 Samuel 30, verse 1, they went back home thinking at least that which the Lord has done, let's at least go and get back home, get some succor and relax, and then sort out things from there, even though it was a period of extreme confusion, extreme anxiety. 1 Samuel 30, verse 1. However, by the time they got back home, everything they had been looted, and their entire city, all their homes, had been burned. Not only that, they found to their horror that all their wives and children had been captured. No wonder that in verse 4 of 1 Samuel 30, David and the people who were with him lifted up their voices and wept until they had no more power to weep. That means there are certain situations and distresses that you will weep to the period where there is no more power to weep. It was so bad that in 1 Samuel 30 verse 6, David was greatly distressed, and his own men spoke, not just thought, of stoning him. And you know that by stoning him, they didn't think about wounding him. They wanted to kill him. They were blaming him for their losses, because these were men who were vagabonds, but came to David. And the Bible, it just shows us the heart of man. Cursed is the man that trusts in man. It says the heart of man is deceitful and desperately wicked. But David, at that point in time, when everything had turned against him, when it seemed that he was totally finished, in 1 Samuel 30 verse 6b, the Bible tells us that David strengthened himself in the Lord his God. And that's the challenge, and that's the command that the Lord has given us in Ephesians 6 verse 10. He says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Don't look to yourself. Don't look to yourself. Look to your God, the one with whom nothing shall be impossible. And in 1 Samuel 30 verse 8, David inquired of the Lord. And the Lord answered him and said to him, pursue, for you shall surely overtake them and without fail recover all. In 1 Samuel, so I say to you who are here today, whatever it is that has been lost, pursue, for you shall surely overtake and without fail recover all in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And in 1 Samuel 30 verses 11 to 17, while pursuing, David took time to show love to a sick man left for dead by his master. And that was the person God used for his deliverance, to take him to where the people who had stolen everything from them, who had raided them, the raiders, the troop, the army that came against them, to take him to where they were. And in 1 Samuel, and so that's a very important lesson there. This is the city of David where the love of God reigns. We must never forget that we must always continue to walk in love. And my prayer for all of us is that we will continually increase and abound in love in Jesus' name. In those sorts of situations, we'll have said, I don't have time to take care of a man who is left wounded. What can he do for me? The people are going, they don't even know where the people went. But David took time and ministered. And it was in that place of ministering to somebody who had been left for dead that God Almighty led him to where the people were. And in 1 Samuel 30 verses 18 to 19, the Bible tells us, so David recovered all. And nothing of theirs was lacking. David recovered all. And in addition, in 1 Samuel 30 verse 20, because the word of God says when you catch a thief, he would have to not restore seven times, sevenfold. Amen? So in 1 Samuel 30 verse 20, David not only recovered all and took all the spoil, he recovered much more than was taken from him. And he testified in 1 Samuel 30 verse 23, the Lord delivered into our hand the troop that came against us. And again, in 1 Samuel 30, verse 26, he shared some of the spoil to the elders of Judah. And in 2 Samuel 2, verse 4, weeks after this event, the men of Judah came and anointed David king. And David never again was a fugitive after this. He prospered, was promoted, and that which the Lord God had promised him manifested in Jesus' name. Welcome to your own season of prophetic manifestation in Jesus' mighty name. And David became very great, such that we, 3,000 years after, are still calling ourselves the city of David. We had Christ himself, when he came 1,000 years after David, was called the son of David. And we are up 3,000 years after. In fact, this country of Israel, short of having the name of Israel, Jacob, every other thing about the country of Israel, including their flag, is the Star of David. It's all themed. It all derives from the exploits of this great King David. So that which the Lord will do for us today will be one. It will be a generational blessing in Jesus' mighty name. And so, David experienced total deliverance. And if you look at Psalm 18. For those of us who come with our Bibles, I don't know whether they have it in the iPad, but on the top of the psalm, you see a title there in Psalm 18. Psalm 18, there's a title on the psalm. And it's to the chief musician, a psalm of David, the servant of the Lord, who spoke to the Lord the words of this song on the day, a day like this day, that the Lord delivered him from the hand of all his enemies and from the hand of Saul. Praise the Lord. So in one day, the Lord we serve is the one with whom 1,000 years is like a day. What will not take 1,000 years to happen ordinarily, God can do it in one day. God created everything that we see in how many days? 6 days, and rested on the seventh. And is the same God yesterday, today, and forever. And this God is no respecter of persons. In fact, the Bible tells us that God does not show any partiality. In fact, the word of God declares in Matthew 11:11 that we who are in the kingdom of God have greater privileges than David. These are Lord Jesus Christ speaking. Then it says, he who is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than him. So what must we do to experience total deliverance today? Because with God, to him who believes, all things are possible. Because with God, nothing shall be impossible. Number one, the most important thing that we must do. And I found out while I was doing my studies that God made it very easy because Christ has paid the price. The works have already been finished. Psalm 34 verse 17 tells us that it's a category of people that are eligible for this great deliverance. It says, the righteous cry out. The righteous cry out. And the Lord hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. It also goes further and it says, many, verse 19, are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him from them all. From them all. From them. From them. From them all. And in Psalm 18, verses 19 to 20, that psalm with that beautiful title from David, 19 to 20, David declared, he also brought me out into a broad place. He delivered me because he delighted in me. Verse 20, the Lord rewarded me according to my righteousness. According to my righteousness, according to the cleanness of my hands, he has recompensed me. And then what's the second thing? So number one, to experience total deliverance today, we must be righteous. Number two, we must cry out to the Lord. Psalm 34 verse 4 says, this poor man cried out, and the Lord heard him and delivered him. the Lord heard me and he said, I sought the Lord, verse 4. And he did, and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. Verse 5, they looked to him and were radiant, and their faces were not ashamed. Verse 6, this poor man cried out, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. And he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And so the word of God declares, our Lord and Master Jesus Christ speaking, in John 16, 23 and 24, it says, most assuredly I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. Ask, including total deliverance, and you will receive, that your joy may be full. Why? Because Mark 10, 27b, with God, all things are possible. Shall we bow down our heads just for a moment? All heads bowed, all eyes closed, please. The question for the moment is, are you righteous? To this month, there has been a month like never, there has never been a month like this in this church, in which the Lord God will declare that this as our month of total deliverance is not a time to take for granted. It's not a time to think there may be another one. No. God Almighty has, in his own grace, apportion this time for all of us as our own season of total deliverance. But for as many as believe, we need to make sure that we are walking and we're in right standing with him as kings and priests. Are you righteous? Are you in right standing with God? Is your name in the book of life? If yes, I want you to signify by raising up your right hand. The Lord Jesus Christ is here. God bless you. You can put your hands down. If you are not, no, and you want to be righteous, I want you to raise up your right hand now. I want you to raise up your right hand now. God bless you. I see that hand. I want you to raise up your right hand now. If no, you are not sure, you are not certain, and you want to make sure to receive his free gift of righteousness, that on that last day, we will not be found wanting, that we would this day receive our own total deliverance. If you're raising up your hand, please raise it up well. Please raise it up well so that we can see it. Yes, my brother outside, I see your hand. If you're in the gallery and you're raising up your hand, please raise it up well. God bless you. I see that hand. God bless you. God bless you. You want to receive the gift of righteousness. You want to receive the gift of righteousness. God bless you. I see that hand. God bless you. I see that hand. You want to receive the gift of righteousness. You want to make sure you are in right standing with God. There is no use coming to church and going back the same way. This is not a time to be trifled with. If you are here, you want to receive his gift of righteousness. The greatest gift of all, his gift of righteousness. Please signify by raising up your hand. Even if you haven't, amen, please signify by raising up your hand. God bless you. I see that hand at the very back. God bless you. If you're raising up your hand, raise it up well so that we can see. So that we can see. If you have received a card, you can put your hands down. If you're not yet received a card, please raise up your hand. Amen. Jesus Christ is here and is going to give you the gift of righteousness, but he just needs you to signify. That's all. He has paid the price already. He has made it easy. And he's offering us a free gift of righteousness, so that we can experience his total deliverance today. If you are here and you have received a card, or you haven't yet received a card, but you want to receive his free gift of righteousness and right standing with God, please rise up on your feet and just come and join me in the front. Amen. God bless you as you come. We wait for you from the gallery. Please come. Or even if you haven't received a card, but you want to receive the free gift of righteousness, please come right now. Please come. Please come. Please come. Please come. You are not here by accident. He ordained from before the foundations of the earth that you should be here. You are the Lord that healeth me. You are the Lord. Please come, even if you haven't received a card and you want to receive his free gift of deliverance. Please come. Please come, we'll wait for you.
You sent your word.
Please come, you're not here by accident. God ordained that you will be here from before the foundations of the earth. Please come, please come. Don't let this moment pass you by. Don't let this moment pass you by. Please come, please come, please come.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord that he led me.
Please come, please come. We're waiting for you. God bless you as you come.
You are the
please come, please come, please come.
My healer.
You are not here by accident. He ordained that you would receive
your
total deliverance today.
Word.
Amen. And he's giving you his free gift of righteousness. Please come, please come. We'll wait for you, my sister. God bless you. If you are still there and you want to receive his free gift of righteousness, please come right now.
Baba, you are the Lord
that he led me.
Baba,
you are the Lord, my healer.
Baba,
you sent your word and healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer.
Brethren, I want you to say these words after me. Heavenly Father, I come to you now in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. Forgive me my sins. Have mercy on me, Lord. I receive you as my Lord. I receive you as my Savior. I receive right now your free gift of righteousness. Write my name in the book of life. Take out of me everything that is not of you. Put back in me all that the enemy has taken out of me. Fill me with your Holy Spirit and help me to live for you. On that last day, let me not be found missing in heaven. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for your gift of righteousness. In Jesus Christ's precious name we have prayed. Amen. Please just wait a moment. Now that we have all received the gift of righteousness and have been made kings and priests unto our God, let's begin to thank him. Right now, this prayer is for all of us. Let's begin to thank him because he is our righteousness. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 1:30, Christ has been made to us wisdom from God, righteousness, redemption, and sanctification. 2 Corinthians 5:21, the Bible says God made him who knew no sin to be sin for us so we might be the righteousness of God in him. Let's thank the Lord Jesus Christ for loving us. Let's thank him for making us, for being our righteousness. Thank him for the gift of righteousness that we can stand boldly as the righteousness of God in Christ, not by anything that we have done, but through faith in what Christ has done for us, the finished work of Christ. Father, I thank you for the gift of righteousness. I thank you that I'm standing righteous before you. Lord, I give you glory, I give you honor, and I give you praise. Let's begin to thank him also, Revelations 1, verse 5 and 6, for loving us, washing us in his blood, and making us kings and priests unto our God, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, that we shall indeed reign upon the earth. Father, we thank you, we bless you, and we exalt you. Let's begin to thank the Lord God for delivering us already from the power of darkness. Father God, we thank you for delivering us from the power of darkness. We thank you for all the deliverances we have experienced all the days of our lives. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for the precious salvation of our souls, for our names that are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Father, we give you praise. We give you thanks. Blessed be your name, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we have prayed. Psalm 34, verse 17. It says, the righteous cry out, and the Lord hears and delivers him from all their troubles. We're going to cry out to the Father right now. We're going to cry out based on Psalm 31, verses 1 to 2, which says, in you, O Lord, I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. deliver me in your righteousness. Bow down your ear to me, deliver me speedily. Let's display both verses, Psalm 31, verses 1 and 2, and begin to cry out to the Father. I didn't say mortar. Cry out to the Lord God Almighty. Cry out to the Lord God Almighty. Father, I cry out to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I put my trust in you. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in your righteousness. Bow down your ear to me. Now, deliver me speedily. Now, deliver me speedily. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, precious Father. Hallowed be your name, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we have prayed. Brethren, this is the year of the Lord's presence, in which the Son of God is manifesting himself. It says in 1 John 3, verse 8, for this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy all the works of the devil. We're going to cry out to the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ himself says, whatever things you ask in my name, John 14, 13 and 14, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. We're going to cry out and we're going to say, Lord Jesus, now, totally destroy every work of the devil in every area of my life. Let's begin to pray in Jesus Christ's precious name. Jesus Christ, you are my Lord. Now, totally destroy every work of the devil in every area of my life, in every area of my family, in every aspect and face of my home, my work, your church, oh God Almighty, in our nation, Father God, now destroy every work of the devil in every area of our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, precious Father. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we have prayed. Psalm 90 verse 16, as God did for David in one day. God is no respecter of persons. We're going to thank the Father for delivering us already. We're going to ask the Father that now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let your work of total deliverance appear in my life. Let's begin to pray in Jesus Christ's precious name. Father God, thank you for delivering me totally already. Thank you, Lord God, I receive total deliverance right now. Lord God Almighty, Father, now in the name of Jesus Christ, let your work of total deliverance appear in my life. This very season, this very day, and today, restore double to me of all my lost years, of all my losses, of all our comforts, of all excellence, of all our lost joys, oh God Almighty. In every area of our lives where we have experienced losses, Lord, restore double to us today. Restore double to us today. Father God, let your work of total deliverance appear now in every area of our lives. Thank you, precious Father. Now, Lord God, we give you glory, honor, and praise. For in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen. Finally, Psalm 16, verse 11. We are in his presence. So just begin to receive fullness of joy and pleasures forevermore. Father God, I thank you for the privilege to be in your presence. I believe I receive fullness of joy and pleasures forevermore. Let's begin to thank him for answered prayers, even as our brethren. Amen. As our brethren go with our pastor, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, my brethren. Let's be thanking God for that which he has done. Fullness of joy, pleasures forevermore. Fullness of joy, pleasures forevermore. Fullness of joy, pleasures forevermore. Fullness of joy and pleasures forevermore. Father God, we give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor.